Hello again, my fellow pilots and aircraft maintenance personnel. Your host is always Haysam Ali, and I am an aviation technical instructor. Today, Aviation Nuggets is cooperating with Easy Memory Item to show you with a good schematic the difference between engine fire and the tailpipe fire. Turbofan jet engines may suffer from two different types of fire. One which is the most common, it is the engine fire or nacelle fire or external fire. And the other type is the tailpipe fire. Tailpipe fire. Why I keep boasting this difference and why I need or we need to showcase the difference between these two types of fire? Airbus do a survey and found that many pilots mistakenly do the procedure of engine fire for the tailpipe fire. And this is totally wrong. And this will not solve any problem with the tailpipe fire. So you as a pilot or as an aircraft maintenance personnel need to clearly identify what is the difference between engine fire and tailpipe fire. This is a very good schematic. Thank you, Tino Janke, my friend. He is the owner and the founder of Easy Memory Item. The difference between engine and tailpipe fire is mainly due to the location. This is the area that an engine fire or external fire will propagate. This is the sensitive area of the engine where a high temperature is located and also a flammable fluid duct running here. So there are located the fire loops or fire detectors in this area. So this is the extinguisher agent distribution zone. When you release the fire bottle, it will extinguish here in the sensitive area, in the external part of the engine or the nacelle of the engine. But on the other side, for the tailpipe fire, it is developing in the combustion chamber or the aft turbine race. This is the tailpipe fire zones. It is an internal fire. If you release the fire bottle, it will do nothing with the internal fire or tailpipe fire. So the first difference between engine fire and tailpipe fire is the location. They are located in different area or they will propagate in totally different area. Keep in mind, the engine fire will propagate in the nacelle, where the fire detector loops are located. But on the other side, the tailpipe fire will develop in the core of the engine from the combustion chamber or from the aft turbine race. And this schematic clearly identifies the location of the extinguisher agent distribution zone and the tailpipe fire zone. Let's go for another good schematic. Again, thank you, Tino, for this good difference between engine and tailpipe fire. We can see here, this is the engine fire and this is the tailpipe fire. First, engine fire is easy to identify. How? Because you will find all the warning in the cockpit will give you alarm about the engine fire. Maybe in the Airbus as a continuous repetitive chime, master warning, indications in the cockpit will indicate the happening of engine fire. But on the other side, the tailpipe fire is coming from the core of the engine. Why it is hard to identify? Because it's an internal fire and no detectors will give you an indication for a tailpipe fire. So what is the main indication of a tailpipe fire? It is a visual report. Visual report. Maybe coming from the ground personnel, ground mechanics that will assist you during engine start or shutdown, from the cabin crew, or from the tower. Okay? So the main indication for tailpipe fire, keep in mind, is a visual report. And the main indication for the engine fire is alarm in the cockpit. Alarm in the cockpit. Okay, so when an engine and tailpipe fire may happen. For engine fire at any time, on ground or in flight. on ground or in flight. But the tailpipe fire is mainly happen on ground only during engine start or shutdown. So the probability of tailpipe fire during engine start or shutdown is very high. So what is the cause? It is due to an excess of fuel in the combustion chamber or the after turbine race. But the engine fire cause is due to a leak, flammable fluid leak in the nacelle area, because as I told you, this is called the sensitive area of the engine. There is a very high temperature there and also a flammable fluid duct running in that area. This flammable fluid duct may be fuel or oil or hydraulic. If it is leak, so there will be a high probability of ignition in the of auto ignite in the nacelle area. Okay, so as you can see here, engine fire detection is based on temperature sensors or fire detection loops, and it will give you an indication in the cockpit. Engine fire will give you a cockpit indication, but the tailpipe fire, due to visual report, detection is based on ground stuff or a visual report from the ground stuff mainly, and no activation of engine fire warning in the cockpit. If you are a good pilot, you will indicate a rapid EGT rise. This is an indication on the ECAM or your display. If you found a rapid EGT rise, it is maybe an indication of a tailpipe fire. But keep in mind again, the main indication for the tailpipe fire is a visual report from ground staff, cabin crew, or the tower. What about the procedure? The procedure for engine fire is to keep in mind or remember isolation, then fire extinguish. So ECAM procedure, you need to shut down the affected engine. You need to isolate the engine by mainly like an Airbus master lever off. Okay, it will cut oil, fuel, hydraulic, okay? And then discharge the fire bottle or fire extinguisher. To easily memorize these steps or procedure, remember always isolations and fire extinguish. Isolations and fire extinguish. But for the tailpipe fire, the quick reference handbook procedure will tell you that you need to shut down the engine to stop fuel flow, and you need to dry crank the engine or make a dry motoring, or you need to engage the starter with the rotor to have air to blow out the residual fuel. Remember, as I told you, that the cause of tailpipe fire is an excess of fuel in the combustion chamber or after turbine race. So you need air to blow out this residual fuel. And you need to keep in mind that don't use the engine fire or agent discharge push button, as they will have no mean to solve the tailpipe fire. For the impact of engine fire, the engine may be suffered big impact on the engine. And for the tailpipe fire, usually very little impact on the engine. Specifically, if you do the procedure of dry cranking or dry motoring as fast as you can. Thank you for your good listening, and always fly safely and maintain your aircraft very safely. And please stay tuned for an upcoming sessions like this. I'm very happy to cooperate with Easy Memory Item. Aviation Nuggets now is cooperating with Easy Memory Item to make the abnormal procedure as easy as we can. Thank you, and please stay tuned for an upcoming sessions like this. Bye bye.